Hi, everyone. Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 13 betas and iOS 14 betas are always fairly buggy. However, with iOS 13, it was considered one of the buggiest betas and even buggiest public releases that we had in a long time. And so what I did, based off a lot of feedback from you, many of you wanted to see a video comparing the two as far as stability and what we remember. So I took a look at iOS 13 betas versus iOS 14 betas, starting with beta 1 and going to beta 3. Now I'm running iOS 13.6 on my iPhone 8 Plus in my left hand, and then I have my iPhone 11 Pro Max in my right hand, that's running iOS 14 beta 3. And so I wanted to talk about what I found by going back to my videos and taking a look at the follow-ups from over a year ago or so. Now, the first thing is with iOS 13 beta 1, there were a lot of issues. In fact, I had said and remember doing this that with iOS 13 beta 1 and 2, it was so bad that I actually rolled back to iOS 12 betas or 12 final versions so that it was more stable and I could use my phone regularly without having a ton of bugs. People were saying there was app compatibility issues and simple tasks such as leaving a comment with the YouTube app, and you'll see I'm installing a bunch of updates right now on my 8 Plus, but leaving a comment, for example, would just crash the app. So you couldn't leave comments on apps, or at least I couldn't. Many people complained of the same. And also people were complaining strangely about Apple removing 3D Touch. Now they technically did not remove 3D Touch. They just simply changed the way it works. Now the iPhone 8 Plus is definitely faster with 3D Touch, but there's still problems with iOS 14 betas. For example, beta 1, while it was fairly unusable on iOS 13 beta 1, iOS 14 beta 1 had some touch input lag. For example, I had the keyboard freeze up on me quite a few times. So as I was scrolling through, or maybe I was just typing, the keyboard would freeze. Also, I had a few resprings where the phone would just sort of restart on its own. And the number one complaint I got was widgets not working. In fact, widgets are still not working up to this point with beta 3, but I would expect that to be fixed in the future. Sometimes, for example, you tap on the widget, it brings you to your real-time forecast with my weather widget, or maybe the weather widget isn't even there at all. So people are still having issues, but they seem to be much more severe on iOS 13. So another example is with beta 2 with iOS 13, what we had was wallpaper crashing the device. So maybe you'd go in, go to your wallpaper, and then change your wallpaper and set it to something different. It would completely crash my device over and over. And I did see this with iOS 14 betas, strangely, but the device would still freeze up. There were overall crashes. Using voice to text in messages, for example, would just crash messages, or crash Twitter if you were using voice dictation or voice to text. Just didn't seem to work. CarPlay had issues, and also a major issue for a lot of people with Apple Music is Apple Music for some people just didn't work altogether. So for example, you'd go into Apple Music and then some people were getting weird responses and saying it needed some sort of code. That was an early on problem, but it seems like they fixed that later on, of course. Now with iOS 14 beta 2, most people said it was really stable. Touch input still gave me issues and some other people, but performance was good. And in general, it was just great. We didn't see that before with iOS 13. In fact, iOS 13 public betas did not come out until a second version of iOS 13 beta 3 was released. Now with iOS 13, they released iOS 13 beta 3 to developers, and then a few days or a week later or so, they released it the public beta. They released the public beta with iOS 14 right after beta 2 or so, and so it's much more stable early on. In fact, beta 3 was much better with iOS 13. It was terrible on the iPad for me, but it had zero app crashes, it was smooth, it had no lockups, and banking apps and things were working for people again. However, battery was not great. In fact, battery was pretty terrible on iOS 13 betas, and the same holds true with iOS 14 betas today. Now, I did find that iOS 13 betas were only getting me about 4 hours of screen on time. So if you were using your battery and just using it as normal, you would get terrible battery life. And that was with 100% battery health. My iPhone 8 Plus currently has 97% battery health, and my iPhone 11 Pro Max has 96 the last time I checked it. So it has 96% battery health. And what I've found is with iOS 14 beta 3, with normal use, I'm getting about 6 or 7 hours of screen on time. That's not great compared to the normal 10 to 12, but it's an early beta. Equally as bad was iOS 13 beta 3, where I was getting about 4 to 5 hours of screen on time on an iPhone XS Max. So Keep in mind, they're early betas, but both of them got much better around beta 3. Beta 3 on iOS 14 still has some issues with mostly the widgets people complain about, and then some touch input issues I'm having with it personally. Beta 3 of iOS 13 was much better, but terrible on iPad. I had all sorts of issues with touch, with watching video, and everything else. So keep in mind, betas in general are going to be fairly buggy. It's just the way they are, but with iOS 14, it seems like Apple nailed it. They've made it much better, and in fact, I would expect iOS 14 beta 4, hopefully by the time you're watching this video, we're only about a few days away from it, but either way, hopefully it gets much, much better. Every other year, Apple seems to improve on them, so I wouldn't expect anything different. iOS 12 is great, 13 not so good, 14 seems to be much better. So give it a few more betas and it'll probably be stable enough for most people to use. And then of course the final release hopefully will be much better than what we had with iOS 13. Now with iOS 12, we were at iOS 12.4 at this time last year. Now we're already at iOS 13.6. That's how many revised or fixed versions we have. And we're still waiting for more versions with iOS 13. Something was changed in the code that made it less stable, less reliable. And with iOS 14, I think we're going to see much better experiences in the future, not only with iOS, but with iPadOS, also with watchOS. Hopefully we see a better experience in general with all the devices this year. It seems like Apple's really focusing on that, including macOS Big Sur as opposed to macOS Catalina. So this year should be the year of stability, but right now, don't worry about it. If you have issues with your widgets, Apple will fix that and they'll update it and it will be much better in the future. Now, I've got two different wallpapers here from iOS 13. This is an older version that I've used, this wallpaper before. I'll link both of them in the description below if you'd like to try them out. If you haven't subscribed already, though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.